ITV drama premieres with HSBC, investing in great British drama.
I want to. I'm doing it because you won't. Remember me? Liz Hoodless. Liz Barnett, as was.
God, Liz. Nancy, what are you doing here? Got a job.
What in cold is?
Not that bad, is it?
I'm a lifer here. Can't afford to have feelings about the place. So, what about you? Last I heard, you were off to college.
Oh, that was ages ago. Bridget Watmore, starting to die.
Wait for it, will you?
Gate 6 cleared. Gate 6 secured. Permission to
open.
Gate 7.
See you around. Got to go with the rest of the slaves.
Sean?
Monday, innit?
God, sod. Stuck for a line every other day of the week. You haven't done this before, have you?
Really? I'm fine.
Hoodless.
Scrub up.
Right, let's get you up and cracking then.
This is Bridget, Mr. Glover. She'll be me when I'm gone at the end of the week.
I see. Don't even dream about it, Bridget.
Not the dreaming sort.
Good, very good. Because those that do go quietly insane, don't they, Barry?
Too right, Mr. J.
Learning not to want. That's the secret of survival in this place.
£180 million.
Bridget, what are you doing down here? I thought you'd have a secretarial job upstairs.
No, a mop job downstairs. It's only temporary. I'll find something better.
I can't believe it. You cleaning. Sit down. How come?
I never finished college. I got pregnant, then another come along and another and... Don, that's my husband. He didn't like there being two breadwinners in the house. Then 3 years ago, he got made redundant, so...
He got the boot and you were desperate. Dear poor cow. I may not be flipping Einstein. At least I stuck at it. I've done pretty well here, actually. Made me a supervisor.
always thought this place was for printing, weren't they?
Oh, it is. Comes back sooner than you'd think. Knackered. We destroy it, too.
Yeah, I saw they burn it. It's amazing. Don't ever think about keeping a bit.
I'll let you into a secret. You see her over there? And him.
And him.
And her. And them. Everybody in this room, in fact. Never stopped dreaming about it.
Don't suppose anyone ever did more than dream.
You're joking. You've seen the security in this place.
This week, we're looking at luxury two-bedroom waterfront apartments. Apartment number one is overlooking Bristol.
Now, this is the reason that most people come to Bath and Leeds, windsurfing, of course. It's kind of Europe's natural way here, but I hear the speech of Eric. Eric?
No, Andy. Eric is the famous wind which blows in Vasiliki Bay. It blows most afternoons at 4 to 5, and when it blows, it really is spectacular.
Which is why all the expert windsurfers come down.
Exactly.
I'm not an expert windsurfer. I've never been near a board before, honestly. Is there any chance, after a quick lesson, that I might be able to stand up?
Well,
it is quite a hard
how was your day?
To learn in an afternoon.
Terrific. If you enjoy being told by some junior down at the job centre that it's your own fault you're unemployed.
Let's not sit about moping, eh?
What do you expect me to do? Clean floors like you do. I'm a manager.
Well, do you think you could manage to do something about that front door? Wouldn't compromise your dignity too much, would it? Maybe do a bit of decorating. Cheer the place up a bit.
Yeah, I get it. Give the old man the illusion he's not completely superfluous. All right, I'll start tomorrow. Now, will you please get off my back? How was your day, anyway?
I cleaned toilets. OK?
Lovely when she pouts, eh?
Get a life, Barry.
Maybe they think you'd be tempted to take a few souvenirs on when your last day.
Who's that then?
The security. The full body surgery tonight.
You always know when they're coming?
Yeah, that's their parking space.
Ladies, gentlemen, attention, please. Now, you don't need me to tell you we're losing a colleague today, because we've already had a whip round.
Yay! Yeah.
This is no ordinary colleague. This is an institution. Now, a lot of people in this room weren't even born when Molly Stern first started cleaning up our mess.
Thanks a bunch.
I won't embarrass you, Molly, by saying how conscientious you've been, because everyone here knows you have. And we all know what a keen garden you are, beavering away on that allotment, all hours, all weathers. So, without more ado, and with best wishes for your retirement, I'm delighted to present you with this token of the bank's esteem. A garden centre voucher for 200 quid. And these.
It's my last day here. I couldn't have him, could I? Oh,
Mr. G.
Hello, boysies. Ooh. Gag him for it.
So why don't you make a move then?
When I'm ready.
Lovely, isn't she?
Likes to flaunt it, don't you think?
Wouldn't you if you look like that?
Not very much.
No, I didn't mean...
Yeah, okay. Right, Mum?
Yeah.
Except I keep thinking something's gone and it's never going to come back. Like the pound note. Vic used to say to me, try and get a quid out. Just one pound note. Sure, it can be done. Didn't it not? No one has.
How do you know?
Well, you're not dreaming again, are you, Bridget?
Well, security's not that brilliant, is it? I mean, that search tonight, if you always know when they're coming, you could get thousands out on another night.
Sweetheart, we've all been through it. You know, people with balls and real savvy have tried to work out a way of doing it and got nowhere. So what chance have you got, eh?
Guess what? Our house is falling down. Subsiding, whatever you want to call it.
Well, at least we're insured, aren't we?
No. Actually, we aren't. I haven't paid the premiums for the last 6 months.
Why didn't you tell me?
Did you really want to know?
God almighty, Don. This isn't going to be much use, is it?
This is exactly my point. I mean, we've got the mortgage, the car needs an MOT, we're behind on the water, the gas, the electric, and now this. I mean, face it. It is pointless cleaning toilets.
At least I'm trying.
Oh, no, I'm not, I suppose.
You're not going to get a management job. You're too old. I'm sorry, Don, but it's time you started facing facts.
Oh, I think the facts speak for themselves, don't they? I'm done for.
Why don't you stop whining, get off your backside and do something about it?
I've tried!
I'll try harder because I can't go on like this! Don? 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 What are you doing?
Go in the bedroom. How could you possibly have fancied a white-haired old git? A little bit of black dye, suddenly I look younger. I feel younger. I can go to interviews now, so I'm only 35.
Wait. That's it. Oh, come here, you genius.
Sweetheart.
get some baby oil for us, will you, babe?
Got a minute?
Yeah. Come in.
Yeah, but I can't do it on an empty stomach, can I?
I'm not having that junk clutching up my front garden any longer! See?
No, I won't stop.
We had a bit of a night last night.
Listen, I wanted to ask you something.
What?
Were you serious when you said that you'd take some money out if there was a way?
Of course I was. And I was serious when I said it was impossible too.
It isn't.
Bridget.
No, listen to me.
No, you listen to me. I've worked at that dump for years. If there was a way of getting the money out, I'd know.
Don't patronise me.
I'm not patronising anyone.
Well, then at least just listen.
Go on then.
First, there's no cameras in the vault.
I know.
I'm the only one allowed in there on me, and no one's watching me.
Even if you manage to get near a cage, how would you get into it?
Well, you've got a key to the white padlocks, haven't you?
Yeah.
So that's where you come in. Now, are you allowed to take the key out of the sorting area?
Probably. Never really thought about it.
You don't have to hand it in or anything when you leave?
Well, no, because it's no use, is it, without the black key?
Right, so... if we could figure a way of opening the black padlocks, we'd have cracked it.
Yeah. And if your auntie could pee standing up, she'd be your uncle. I'm telling you, Bridget, only Glover's got a key to the black ones. It's impossible.
You're wrong. Meet me in the toilets tomorrow at 11. Bring your key.
Naughty girl.
Sorry?
You've missed something.
I wouldn't take it from him. No, nor would I most days. Is it Jackie?
Yeah.
Do you fancy going out for a drink tonight?
What? You and me?
I was thinking of asking Liz Udlis as well.
Liz Udlis? Why'd she want to drink with me?
Go on. I don't know many people. It'd be nice.
Oh, OK. Yeah, why not?
See you later, then.
For me, will you?
It's black. I've only got a key to the white ones.
Just try it.
I don't get it, eh? Black paint, you devious. Hold on. You still need to get it on a cage.
I thought of that. Jackie.
I hardly know her. Anyway, we don't really get on.
I think it's time you did.
And that's what you want me for?
Obviously. Can't do it on our own. I mean, we pay her.
Split it equally, she means. And you were sure I'd do it? What if I turn out to be honest?
Come on.
What's that supposed to mean?
We could all be bloody rolling in it by the weekend. What is your problem, you stuck-up tart?
Liz. My problem is this, you fat-ass cow. If I was going to get involved with something like this, it would have to be with someone I trusted. And I wouldn't trust you as far as I could throw you. Either of you. and a drink. Oh. That's it then. What if she reports us? She's got no proof. Told you we dreamed, didn't I? Still, nice dream while it lasted, eh? Money for sweets, Jason. You seen any fags about, Mum?
I thought you were giving up, love.
Just trying to cut down, that's all.
Well, that's good, because it isn't good for you.
That is not why I'm trying to cut down. I like smoking. I'm just trying to cut down because I can't sod him while I fold it.
Jacqueline! Jackie, what's got into you?
I'm sick of being perpetually skint.
Well, you wouldn't be skint if you hadn't booted Steve out. And Errol. And Robbie?
I booted them out because I'd rather be skint than bloody beholden.
I never minded being beholden to your dad.
Yeah, well, times have changed, Mum. Women aren't prepared to put up with all that crap from men in return for money. And anyway, Steve, Darrell and Robbie never had no money anyway.
Take the money from the holding vault here, where it's already been checked and accounted for. It's dead money waiting to be incinerated.
Are you sure the guard isn't going to notice the mock's just been sprayed over?
What else can we do?
Try and buy one like it?
You can't, Liz. I remember Glover saying they're made specially for the bank.
What about the smell of paint?
Cleaning fluid we use in the toilets will mask that. It really stinks.
Look, are you up for this or not, Liz?
I've said I'm bloody up for it. I don't want to get caught. Yeah, much better. He still smells of paint. That works.
Okay, watch me. It's not bad. I'd never know you was holding it.
Well, I spent hours practicing.
You can't have the white key for more than 10 minutes. I managed to smuggle it out of the sorting room yesterday. I was away exactly 10 minutes. Got back, Glover was standing there with a face like thunder waiting for me to open the next cage with him.
Bloody hell. I've got to transfer the key, get into the holding vault, undo the lock, steal the money, then...
Then we'll do it in 10 minutes. So I think we've covered everything.
Yeah, I reckon.
Think so.
Right. Ready for the real thing?
Yeah, bollocks. Let's go for it.
Jack?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Friday, then. Backing out now.
I do hope you're using this equipment for the purpose it's intended.
Mr. J?
What am I always saying, Barry?
The secret of working here is not to want.
The secret of life is not to want, Barry. Dreaming of flesh you can't have is as bad for you as money you'll never have. Afternoon, Mrs. Hoodless.
Mr. Glover.
Right, let's get you cracking then.
Thanks, Sean.
OK.
He's a pig in shit.
Thank you.
for as much as you two.
We'll get going.
We'll divvy it up properly outside.
I see. Right. Let's get you cracking then.
Been playing for the weekend?
About the usual. Quick trip to Mustique. Good job they pay us so well, innit?
Have a good one, yeah?
Yeah. You're putting on weight, my love. Still. It's all going in the right places.
See ya.
You dropped something. Your ID card. Eyes like a hawk, me.
Sure, Don's not in.
Friday night, he does the shopping. It'll be quick, though. I've got to meet him down there in half an hour. We did it.
We got the Bank of England.
I told you we could do it. I told you.
You'll be right.
I was walking along the Broadway and I had a brainwave.
We should do the shopping late on a Saturday, when everything's been marked down in
price.
You could go to prison.
I'm not going to prison. But Dom, let's get this in proportion. Firstly, no one's going to find out, and second, no one gets hurt.
Yeah, but it's still theft. Oh, we're honest people. I mean, we're the sort of people, if we found a wallet in the street, we'd hand it in.
That's because it's someone else's money. This is money no one wants anymore. They was going to burn it. No one suffers.
Yeah, well, it still feels wrong.
Look, I didn't want you to find out about this, but I'm sort of glad you did now. Because you'd have found out eventually.
You're not thinking about doing this again?
Yeah. We only got a few grand out today. Do you think that's going to give us back the life we had? Look, I'm going to go out and get a bottle of wine and a takeaway. What do you fancy, Chinese or Indian? Cool. I suddenly feel really hungry.
You're actually going to spend that money?
I'm going to do this, Don. So you better get used to it. But I'd much rather we was in this together. When hearts are as a
shit. I thought I finally had a buyer for all that garden stuff. I loads it all up, takes it over to Romford for him, unloads it, and then he tries to pay me with a cheque. I said, I don't touch cheques, mate. I'm a cash man. He said he don't touch cash, so I said, well, we've got a bit of an impasse in, mate, haven't we?
Poor you.
Bloody hell. What's going on?
Somehow, thought you might want cheering up.
I thought we were going down a pub.
We could go later.
Yeah, all right, why not?
You go up, I'll follow you. From work.
How?
Never mind how.
Oh, you bloody ingenious.
Hiya. What's this? It's called shopping, Mum. Badge up. Right. I've got something for everyone.
It's a bit OTT, isn't it?
Nice. Liz recommended it.
There's Bridget.
Don't know the girls.
Indeed.
This is Bob.
All right, Don, what a gaff, eh?
Yes.
Oh, lovely, lovely. Here we go, mate. Thank you very much. And, quick change.
We were just saying we could get used to this.
All right, ladies, here we are. You ready?
Yeah.
No, you'll be all right, don't worry. Here we are. Here we go.
I'm going to do it all.
Yeah. Spain, Cyprus, Greece.
Hey, that's Versace, I reckon.
Get yourself one of them from next week's take.
Yeah, I might well do that.
The other thing I love about Spain, right, is them pesetas. Because, like, you give them a tenner, and they give you thousands of them in your change. You feel like a king. Well, we are kings now.
Yeah, we are.
And queens.
All courtesy of the bank. She's done. Love ya.
Look, I don't think this is going to be very popular, but I think we need to have a serious discussion.
What's to discuss? We had no money, now we've got money.
That's right.
About the situation, what are we going to do with all the money?
We'll spend it, of course. Can't wait to get going.
You don't think anyone's going to notice? My husband's redundant, your husband's a...
virtual bankrupt.
Oi, bankrupt?
And all of a sudden we're buying flash cars, clothes, going on expensive holidays. I mean, how long do you think it's going to be before somebody notices? How long before somebody works out that you three work for the Bank of England?
What are you saying? We've got to be smart. We've got to be careful.
We've got to keep what we spend within strictly agreed limits.
Bollocks.
I thought we'd come here to celebrate, not get a bloody lecture.
Yeah, the whole point of having money is to spend it.
I'm only saying we've got to be careful.
We don't want to be careful. We want to have fun.
If you carry on the way you are now, you are bound to get caught.
Bridget!
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to come out like that.
Bridget!
A taxi to Debden, please, as soon as possible. Thank you. What?
You didn't have to be so pompous.
Who's pompous?
They'd have listened, I'm sure. They'd go and get all personal.
But don't blame me. That oaf in there, eh?
Look, I'm sorry, Bridget. I was only trying to be realistic. I honestly think the only way out of this mess is for me to get a proper job and start bringing home the bacon again.
What? I'm not having other people tell me how to spend my money.
No, I think they've got a point.
Yeah, me too.
Point? What bloody point?
What? People are bound to notice if we suddenly start throwing money around.
Where are you going?
Mind if we share your cab?
It's silly to waste money.
Nah, of course not. Sorry it all blew up like that.
No, you were right.
Yeah, we need to keep a lid on it. It's just the idea of having money, not being able to spend it.
As it happens, Don's come up with a solution. What if we send our men out to work?
I do work. Sometimes.
Who's going to employ them?
We will.
To do what?
Don't matter. Play golf, tennis, take up bungee jumping for all I care.
Just make sure you're out of the house every day between 9 and 5.
And we'll pay you, what, 500 a week? And everyone will think you're bringing home the bacon. That's right, isn't it, Don?
Yeah, that's right.
That's really clever. What about me?
Oh, that's easy. You invent yourself a rich boyfriend.
Yeah, I suppose I could do that.
It's brilliant! Bob?
Yeah, all right then.
All right. Let's hear it for the Debden mob.
The Debden mob!
Morning.
Did you join your job, Don?
Oh, yeah. In fact, they offered me a promotion, but it would have meant moving. We're very settled here.
You're obviously doing all right, all the money you're spending on the house.
Well, we're not spending that much. It's all just sensible renovation. And we believe in living within our means, don't we?
Oh, absolutely.
I expect you'll be a lady of leisure again soon, Bridget.
No, not just yet. I'm still finding the job quite rewarding, actually.
See you later, love.
Bye.
Yourself
nice.
Yeah. Bob wanted to go to the Seychelles.
Seychelles? What? You told him you thought that was too flash. What?
No, she told him you think that was too flash. Just like she said that you'd go mad if you bought that Mitsubishi Shogun he wanted, or the Rolex, or the new bathroom she wants.
You've just had a new bathroom. It's very nice.
Yeah, I know, but I saw another one I liked. It's beautiful. Gold taps, marble, whirlpool jacuzzi.
You can't possibly have that.
We've got to be sensible.
Not this sensible.
What's up?
We're bored. Well, we seem to be spending more time doing this than anything else. And for what?
The money?
Bridget, how much was a tape this week?
It's, 11,000. It's £2,000 up on last week. I'm getting picky, see? Yeah, I only go for tenners and twenties. I don't bother with fivers anymore.
Then, for God's sake, let's spend some more, then. We can't just keep letting it build up like this. Right out of hiding places.
Yeah, I want to go out and enjoy myself instead of making up stories about Martin.
Who's Martin?
My rich, imaginary boyfriend. I want a real boyfriend. I want to be living it up.
Me too.
Now, come on, you know what we agreed. That you get to... I'd get tempted too, but we can't take risks. What you've got to do is enjoy what we do spend, and...
What?
Well, just keep telling yourselves there's pleasure in saving money as well as spending it. Because there is, isn't there?
What's the secret, then?
Good spuds. Nice, deep trench. Plenty of dung.
I love new potatoes.
No taste like it.
That bloody hard work.
It is. Worth it when you see the fruits of your labours.
Put a couple of rows in for me, would you? I'll pay you for the seed.
You can do it yourself if you want.
Liz and Jackie quite well, don't you?
Yeah.
Not silly girls, are they?
No. Odd question to ask.
No, it's not. I don't make friends easily. I've been let down a lot in the past. No, I'm sure they're good mates. You know, dependable.
You can trust them, if that's what you mean.
Good.
Go with the flow, girl. That's what I do.
Builders are finished, then?
Yeah, finally. It's all right, isn't it? I asked them to give us a quote on a new conservatory. What do you think?
All in good time, love. Everyone's agreed on a weekly spending limit. We don't want to be the ones to rock the boat. Well, we're careful. We can use this to set us up for life. And that's what it's all about. Isn't it, love? Hey?
Excuse me for a moment, Mr. G.
sandwich.
Right. Gate. Get on with it. We have a cremation.
Whoops. Sorry, Mr. Glover.
Nice to see somebody enjoying their work, eh, lad?
Your lift.
No, thanks.
Get in the car, Jackie. Or I'll call Mr. Glover and we'll search you here, in the street.
Where are we going?
Bloody hell, what's going on there?
Right then. Let's see it.
See what?
What you've got in your underwear. Hot.
So what's your problem?
Hey?
What am I supposed to have done wrong?
You nicked it, ain't you?
Prove it. If you searched me outside the factory, you might have had evidence. But you ain't got any now.
Well, I've got this.
You stole that.
What?
You nicked it, then threatened me that if I didn't sleep with you, you'd accuse me of taking it.
You liar!
Well, who's going to believe you? Everyone in that factory knows how much you've been harassing me. Plus, your fingerprints are all over that now.
You bitch. Yeah, all right. All right, you've done me this time. But I'll tell you something. You'll never be able to do this again. Because I'll be watching you and the rest of them every minute of every day.
It's up to you.
Well, don't look so pleased with yourself. Your little scam's over. Get out. Go on.
Well, this is not going to report us.
Yeah, well done, Jack. Bloody fast thinking.
It was fun while it lasted, eh? Unless what? Suppose we offer to cut him in?
You mad? He's on security.
That's too risky. No. Oh, I'm sorry, girls. I think we're gonna have to call it a day. You on your own?
Yeah, but...
Harry? Who is it? Is it Sean?
No, Mum. It's no one you know.
introduce me, then. Berry, the girl.
Name's Jackie.
Oh, that's nice. Barry doesn't have a lot of friends. Not surprising, is it? Lumbered with me every evening.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Mrs. Weller.
And you, love.
I'll see you in a minute, Mum.
No rush.
She's not very well. You better come upstairs.
I've been talking to the others and we're prepared to cut you in.
I can't do that. I'm security.
But it'd be worth $3,000 or $4,000 a week. Think about it. It'd be like winning the pools every week.
And what if we get caught?
Where's the risk? You know everything about security. Your glove is right-hand man. If you came in, we'd be invincible. Oh, come on. I've seen you looking at the money.
Everyone looks. And there's a big difference between looking and touching, right?
Well, I've seen you looking at something else, too.
What do you mean?
You know what I mean.
What?
I mean, the answer's yes, if you still want to.
What, you'd let me?
If you come in with us.
Jack?
Sit down. Thank you, Don. We asked you to come in on this because we had to. And now that you are in on it, you do things our way or we close the operation down. Two rules. One, you never spend more than 500 a week.
Fair enough.
And second, you don't breathe a word about this to anyone, including your mother.
Of course not.
Good.
Sit down, Barry. We haven't finished. Jackie.
She offered, right? She made all the running.
You took advantage, you bastard.
She did what she thought she had to do to keep things going. If you think that entitles you to jump into bed with her whenever you fancy, you have got another think coming. We're making ourselves clear.
Yeah. Quite clear.
Good.
No, that's wrong.
What? No.
This bit has got. Look, this can't be right.
Well, yeah, I mean, we'll turn it around, it'll be right.
It's lovely. Must have cost you a bomb.
Ah, we club together, Molly.
God, they make such a meal of things.
Vic was exactly the same. No! No, no! No! No, come on, Mol!
No! You all right, Jackie?
Look, Jack, we know what it must have taken.
Now, all I've done is confirm what you already thought about me. That I'm a cheap little tart.
We never thought that. We're really grateful.
I didn't do it for you. I did it for me and the kids. Well, it's done now. You can get on and start enjoying the money again.
Oh, Jackie.
I'm already
miserable.
No. Hey, what would you say if I said we could loosen the purse strings a bit?
Are you serious?
Well, maybe I've been a bit of an ogre.
What'd you think?
You look gorgeous.
Oh, jeez, yeah, there was another one I liked, but, well, I just couldn't decide. So I got them both!
Ready?
Oh, Barry. It's lovely. I'm not going to ask questions, love, about where it's all coming from. I'm really enjoying what it all means.
Yeah, me too.
But you can't just get your happiness from making me happy. For a start, I'm not going to be here forever.
Shut up.
What do you really want for yourself?
I don't know.
You must know.
Maybe.
She's lovely, isn't she?
So what do you think?
Well, split four ways, it'll only cost us 40 grand a piece.
Gotta be worth it, ain't it?
Oh, yeah. We've booked for the QE2 in March.
Who needs a QE2 when you got this?
Yeah. You could almost imagine you're in Magaluf.
Do you mind if I...
Do you want? Hush, Mum.
Not too good at the moment.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Oh, she has her ups and downs, like the rest of us. Listen, you know... Well, you know...
Yeah. What about it?
Well, I just wondered if you'd like to go out with me one night, just somewhere. No, I don't mean like that. I mean as friends, no strings or nothing, just go pictures or meal or that.
Why would you want to go out with me?
Because I really like you, Jackie. I've always liked you.
What a lovely day. I said to Bob, we're going to have to get together like this more often. What's this?
It's bloody Mrs. Next Door.
Well, drive on. Drive on past!
Don't be stupid, don't panic.
Burglar alarm. I knew you was out, so I called the police.
Oh,
the police have been in there a while. I can't imagine what they've found. Yeah, that's a lovely new three-piece suite you've got in there. And that new kitchen, that must have set you back a bit.
Mr. and Mrs. Watmore.
Yes, right.
There's no intruders.
Oh. Alarm was probably set off by a bird flying into the window or something.
Possibly. We've made a thorough search of the house. We've found something that concerns us. It was in the fruit bowl.
Really?
Very, very careless, if you don't mind me saying, Mrs. Watmore. It was in full view at a dining room window.
I mean, seriously, what casual thief would be able to resist the sight of so much money?
No. No, absolutely, Constable.
Now then, please, take my advice. If you must keep large quantities of cash in your house, keep it out of sight. Preferably in a safe, all right?
All right.
Well, all's well that ends well. This time, anyway.
Thank you, Constables.
I'm sorry. You said get some money. I didn't know.
I don't care why you did it. You shouldn't have. We've let this whole thing get out of hand.
Well, you said to push the boat out a bit.
Yeah, we pushed it out too far. We've got to cut back. We can start by telling Bob and Barry that bloody boat's got to go back. The party's over, Don.
I'm not going back to where it was before, and Barry says he won't either. I've seen this flat in Woodford I'm going to get.
You're not buying it, Jackie, and that's final.
Piss off! You've all got nice houses, why shouldn't I?
But you're right, Jack. Bridget can't tell you what to do. It's your money. Our money.
Yeah, but...
But what?
Well, we've always agreed before, the three of us.
Well, it's not just the three of you now, is it? It's me, and Don, and Bob. Well, how about a bit of democracy? Just started enjoying ourselves. We're living the lifestyle we deserve. You should have whatever you want.
Am I what you want, Barry?
Yeah. Big time.
You've got to see it from her point of view. She's young. She's got herself a fella at last. And she's got a bloody great pile of money burning a hole in her pocket.
We've overstepped the mark.
Oh, come on, that nosy cow's your neighbour. Sorry, Bridge, it's your problem.
It's all our problem. We're going to have to cut right back.
You needn't think Bob and I are cancelling that cruise.
We'll have to.
No way. Bob and I have been really looking forward to it.
You're not... won't let you.
What are you talking about?
You can't go, and that's final.
Who the bloody hell do you think you are, eh? It's my money, and I'll do what I bloody well want. And so will Jackie. So stuff ya. What's the matter?
I never took any.
What?
I'm not taking any more until we agree terms.
You bloody cow.
Christ's sake, Bridget, that's not bloody fair.
What's going on?
Is you okay? You're locked. Either we stop, or we do things my way, and you start towing the line. Are you getting this, Barry? What's it gonna be? Let me know what you think. I'll be on me rounds.
Why are you letting that cow tell you how to spend our money?
Nobody tells me what to do. I didn't like it when she first said it. But I've been thinking it through.
I was really looking forward to going snorkeling in the Maldives.
Look, what other choice do we have, huh? You were on the point of going bust when we started all this. And don't tell me you'd have pulled a rabbit out of an hat.
Yeah, well, I would have.
Bollocks, and you know it. You've not done a proper day's work in years. Look, all I'm saying is... do what the rest of us are doing. Start being sensible.
Hmm? Mr. Glover, Detective Sergeant Markham from the Fraud Squad.
Fraud Squad?
Would you like a brief chat with us?
Of course.
We're looking into the possibility that one of your employees has appropriated a large quantity of money from the plant.
I'm sorry.
You don't think that's possible?
Possible? It's unthinkable. Who is it?
Elizabeth Hoodless.
Hope you're using that camera for the purpose it was intended, Mr. G. Sorry. It's a joke.
Take this cage back to the sorting room.
Why, Mr. Glover?
Recount.
Get cracking. You go on, I'll be up in a minute.
Mr. Glover will be with you in a sec. He wants to recount this one.
Recount it? Why?
Didn't say.
Just go in the toilet. Back to the sorting room with it. He's got the dodgy lock on.
Oh, Jesus.
What are we gonna do?
I'll take this back up to the sorting room. I'll be with you in a minute. Quick!
Barry?
What? Do you hear? Cage 22 has been taken back to the sorting room.
Shit.
Now find Mr. Glover and distract him.
Ow!
Well, I don't know. Use your brain.
Where's Glover?
Not sure. On his round somewhere.
Gate! Right. Let's get this checked again, shall we?
What were we doing that, Mr. Glover? All the paperwork tallies?
I'm sure it does. New security measure. Problem, Mrs. Hoodless?
No, of course not. Jessup, we've double-checked here. I did it personally.
Good. Good, very good. If you wouldn't mind opening the lock. Thank you. In a minute.
Security breach!
Wait here.
Gate!
Sean, give me a hand.
I'm just going to lock this cage up again till Mr. Glover gets back, OK?
OK.
Sure,
would
you? Oh,
it's you. I thought the camera had gone down.
It's covered in dust. It's the static attracts it. I'm surprised you could see anything.
I walked in and they were just there.
Well, now, I think we may have a problem.
Mr. Glover?
It may seem impossible, but I think you may have stumbled onto something.
That's just a couple of notes.
No. It's just the tip of the iceberg. I think it's something much bigger.
What?
I don't know how it's done. Yet. I want you to keep a very special watch on Liz Hoodless.
Just her?
Initially. Watch her every move. I want names of everyone that she associates with in the factory.
Someone must have been careless.
Don't look at me.
I've been really careful.
It can't have been me. Glover wouldn't have put me on the case.
Well, it's Liz they're on to.
Don't look at me, I've been really careful too.
Yeah, me and all, I've even started bloody saving.
What do you mean?
Yeah, love, I said this had Mutual Reliance Platinum Plus bonds.
And you bought one?
No. I bought 100 grand's worth. Well, it looks a bloody good deal to me. I couldn't leave the money lying around the house, could I?
You bloody fool.
What?
Let me just get this straight. You took £100,000 worth of our notes into a bank.
Yeah, I mean, well, everyone kept going on about being more sensible.
Oh, my God. What am I going to do?
Do anything! It's over. We're rumbled. This is the end. Bridget?
Oi, you can't just walk out. You're in the shit.
Yeah, bye. And you put yourself there, didn't you?
There's only one thing for it. Gotta get the money out of our houses. Now. Now! Get all the money in the kitchen now.
What's going on?
Just do it, Don! There's someone watching our house.
What's up?
They're watching Bridget.
Bloody hell.
We've got to get rid of it all.
Yeah. Rob's just filling up suitcases now. I thought I'd leave it at my sister's till...
No! Destroy it! If they're watching our place, they're bound to have you staked out. The minute you walk out, they'll grab you.
Oh, God. We can't just destroy it.
But what choice have we got? Just do it!
Can I help?
help you?
Detective Sergeant Markham, Fraud Squad.
Mary, what's going on? What are these policemen doing here?
Nothing to worry about, Mum. They've made a mistake, that's all.
And a warrant for your arrest on suspicion of theft from the Bank of England. Where did you get the deposit for the bungalow?
I've been saving for years.
Give us the names of the others, Barry, while there's still an opportunity to cooperate.
Piss off.
Come on. You want to confess? I know you do. But you don't want to drop your mates in it. We understand. What happens to your mum while you're in prison? What happens when she gets thrown out of that bungalow you're buying? That won't be much fun for her, will it? But help us, and you get a much lighter sentence. Token, even.
Not only that. The bank have agreed they won't come after you for the bungalow.
My mum can stay there.
You'll only do a few months. And when you get out, you can make a fresh start. Well, then it'll be yours. It's not looking good, sir.
We have a confession.
We don't know how much or for how long they've been taking him. All we've really got is the fact that they've spent a lot of money. And the word of a self-confessed thief who they can say has done a deal with the bank to keep his house.
That idea did come from the bank rather than us, sir.
Because we wanted to secure a conviction.
We've done the best we can, sir.
Are you telling me that these thieving scum are going to walk away from this scot-free?
Steady on, Mr. Glover. If the police are going to be lily-livered about this, we most certainly aren't. We'll damn well prosecute them through the civil court.
The Bank of England's case rests on two planks of evidence. One, the implausibly lavish lifestyle enjoyed by the defendants. The other, the testimony of Mr. Barry Weller. I take note of the fact that the chief witness for the plaintiff is a self-confessed thief and enjoyed various advantages by giving evidence. Indeed, I have been moved to wonder during these proceedings whether anyone who hails from Essex is capable of telling the truth. Nevertheless, I am forced to conclude that if Mr. Weller is a liar, it is extremely fortuitous for the bank that he picked such financially interesting people. The very dishonest Mr. Hoodless, a man who was able to deposit £100,000 in cash in a bank, yet was unable to produce one document to show how he came by it.
Work hard, play hard, and don't let the tax man have too much. That's my philosophy.
He picked Miss Jacqueline Hagger, who claims that her earnings come from a dubious kind of modelling.
I did glamour work. Okay.
And finally, he picked Mrs. Watmore, a woman who expects us to believe that she was able to pay off her mortgage, repair and refurbish her house, and support her unemployed husband, all on the wages of a cleaner. On the best analysis available, I am satisfied that they have each stolen not less than £250,000. There will be a judgment against Watmore, Hoodless and Hagger, for which their spouses will be jointly responsible, of that amount.
Oh, it's terrible out there. You all were good at dressing right for the occasion.
Oh, it wasn't raining when I left.
If only I'd kept a closer eye on Bob.
Listen, if it hadn't been your bugger, it would have been mine.
Well, I should have known never to have trusted a man. Sweethearts, they're all the same. Men. Take a bloody good idea, sort it up every time it's in their genes.
Oh, I'm glad we did it, though. At least we had a taste of being rich.
Yeah, but once you tasted the life, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, the best thing about it... I mean, don't get me wrong, because I loved having the money. But the best thing is, we're mates now.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
You ready, then?
Ready as we'll ever be.
Perfect day for it.
Says even if we flog everything, as is contents, watches, CDs, we'll be lucky to clear that much.
John was saying we'll have to pull in our belts so tight we'll hardly be able to breathe.
Thank you.